An assurance from NBA superstar LeBron James. The King says his family is together, safe, and healthy. This as James's eldest son was released from hospital days after suffering a cardiac arrest. For more on this story, head on over to news.abs-cbn.com. An artist from Argentina uses artificial intelligence to take a peek at what could possibly be the present adult appearance of children who disappeared during the country's bloody military dictatorship in the 70s. Take a look.
This is what a child who disappeared during Argentina's bloody military dictatorship could look like today.
And the response was always the same. I can't believe it. It's exciting.
A project by an Argentine artist uses artificial intelligence to imagine what the children of those who went missing after a military coup in 1976 would look as adults. After Argentina's 1976 military coup, about 30,000 people were killed or disappeared. Around 500 of them were children and babies. Grandmothers and mothers of the victims formed an activist group called the Abuelas of Plaza de Mayo. They advocate for answers about their loved ones and has since located 132 children. Santiago Barros says he has always wanted to support Abuela's mission. The artist uses the Midjourney app to combine photos of the disappeared parents from the public archive of the Abuela's website. He then creates the likely faces of their children as adults today.
I always choose images where the person is looking at the camera, because I think that by entering the profile and finding all these people, the images of these people with their eyes, in a way, they are questioning you and reminding you of that horror. They are still alive. These people still have their identity, which hasn't been returned. And that this is a crime that's being committed every day.
The Abuelas thanked Barros's initiative, but noted that DNA testing remains the only reliable identification method. An Abuelas member, Esteban Herrera, has been looking for his half-brother for decades.
Does this visibility work? Yes, it does. But we want people to know that the AI project is not an official project of the Abuelas and the institution, but from another person who was sensitive to the cause and wanted to collaborate with the search. It's an artistic view that uses an artificial tool for imagination, but it's not conclusive. These images could be touching, but they could generate a different person from the one we are searching for.
U.S. prosecutors broadened their criminal case in the classified documents probe against Donald Trump, citing an incident in which Trump bragged about a plan of attack against another country in an interview. Now, special counsel Jack Smith has charged the former president with willfully retaining classified records. This adds to the 37 criminal counts Trump already faces in the case. Smith also brought new criminal charges against a maintenance worker at Trump's Mar-a-Lago resort in Florida, who is alleged to have helped hide sensitive government documents from officials who tried to recover them. Trump pleaded not guilty last month to federal charges of unlawfully retaining the classified government documents after leaving office in 2021 and obstructing justice. The White House rules out the possibility that U.S. President Joe Biden would pardon his son, Hunter. The younger Biden is facing charges of failing to pay taxes on more than $1.5 million in income in 2017 and 2018. Hunter's deal with prosecutors to plead guilty to tax charges and avoid a gun charge collapsed on Wednesday when the judge said more time was needed to review their agreement. The camp and allies of former President Donald Trump had criticized the deal, saying it unfairly favors Biden's son. Ukraine has recaptured the southeastern village of Staramayorska from Russian forces. That's according to Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky. The village lies to the south of a cluster of small settlements that Ukraine claimed during a counteroffensive which began early in June. Russian troops hold swathes of southern and eastern Ukraine. Zelensky touts what he called as very good results from Kiev's forces, but he also acknowledged slow progress in their counteroffensive. The European Central Bank mirrors the Fed's move and raised interest rates by 25 basis points. This, as the bank said, inflation is still expected to remain too high for too long. This is the ninth straight time the ECB has raised its main rate, bringing it to a historic high of 3.75%. That's its highest level since 2000, before Euro bank notes and coins were even put into circulation. Now, the bank also leaving the door open to more increases.
The near-term economic outlook for the euro area has deteriorated, owing largely to weaker domestic demand. High inflation and tighter financing conditions are dampening spending. This is weighing especially on manufacturing output, which is also being held down by weak external demand. Housing and business investment are showing signs of weakness as well.
President Marcos doubts whether the Senate can get the support of the United Nations for a resolution that calls out China's aggression in the West Philippine Sea. Senator Risa Ontiveros filed that resolution, urging the Foreign Affairs Department to elevate the sea row to the UN. Ontiveros believes the move could complement the country's arbitral win at The Hague. But President Marcos thinks otherwise.
The United Nations entertains governments, not parts of government, not the judiciary of one government or the executive. The senator is free to file whatever resolution she wants, but I do not know how that will translate to any action that will reach the United Nations General Assembly.
President Marcos is back home after securing $285 million worth of investment pledges during his state visit to Malaysia. More in this report.
The Petronas Twin Towers in Kuala Lumpur glimmer in the Philippine flag's colors to mark President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s three-day visit to Malaysia. It is also here in the Petronas Towers where Malaysian Prime Minister Anwar Ibrahim and other top officials hosted a state dinner on Wednesday for President Marcos and his delegation. Marcos's last day in Kuala Lumpur was packed with meetings with Malaysian business leaders. During the Philippine Business Forum on Thursday afternoon, the president enumerated various trade and investment opportunities in the country, as well as his administration's policies and programs aimed at strengthening the Philippine business climate. While Malaysia is the fourth largest source of the Philippines' foreign investments, Marcos believes it is time to take this further.
I think that it's time that with the new transformation, and this provides many new opportunities, and that will give us a chance to increase that level of trade that we have been achieving over the past many years.
The president's state visit brings home up to $285 million in investment pledges from Malaysia. Among those who expressed interest in investing in the Philippines is Malaysian dairy brand Farm Fresh Berhad. It plans to invest $20 million to establish a 400-hectare dairy farm in Batangas or Laguna. This does not include the $300 billion rail project agreement between the two countries. According to Marcos, Malaysian investors also expressed interest in investing into food processing, aviation, logistics, manufacturing, infrastructure, water and wastewater treatment in the Philippines.
We are committed and will continue to commit our support to Malaysian investors. I thank you for your interest and your confidence, and I look forward to the Malaysian business community coming to the Philippines together and working together with the Filipino counterparts in partnership to unlock value not only in our two countries but in our entire region.
The president also says many are interested in investing in the Maharlika Investment Fund. Despite the controversy surrounding Malaysia's own sovereign wealth fund, 1MDB, which led to the imprisonment of former Malaysian Prime Minister Najib Razak.
I am consistently saying it is going to be run professionally and without undue political influence. Of course, the government has an interest in the fund, So we have a representative on the board, but on the day-to-day decisions as to what investments are to be made, it is left to those financial managers that that we will be putting into place. So with that assurance, I feel that they do not I think the assumption is that everyone has learned the lessons from that from what happened with their own sovereign funds. And
meanwhile, the president also ensured that his trip to Malaysia did not hamper government response efforts to Typhoon Igai.
None of the agency heads on these disaster responses are here. I am getting twice daily reports from Secretary Gatchalian and from Pagasa and from the Coast Guard, Admiral Abu. So I'm in constant touch. We were hit harder really up north. Talagang kami ang tinamaan, Cagayan, across hanggang Isabel, Ilocos Sur, Abra, ang laki ng flooding at saka high winds. Maraming bumagsak na puno. So, well, we did what we always do when we are anticipating a storm.
Following his state visit to Kuala Lumpur, President Marcos went to Johor Bahru to meet with their sultan, who is poised to become Malaysia's next king.